in the surrounding. Now, in this lesson, we are going to study the three states of the substances. What are the three states of the substances? Solid, liquid, and gaseous substances. So, there are three states of substance, that is solid, liquid, and gaseous. Okay? So, in this lesson, we are going to study its states and properties. Now, name the solid, liquid, and gaseous states of water. Now, what is the gaseous state of water? When the water is boiling, that time you can see the steam, vapors. Okay, that is the evaporation of the water that is in the form of gaseous. Water already is a liquid, so water is a liquid. And when the water is kept in the ice box in the refrigerator, it takes place of solid. So ice is a solid form of water. Liquid form of water, as water is kept in the normal temperature, that is liquid form. And gaseous means when the water is boiling, that time the water evaporates in the form of steam, that is called as evaporation. That is called as evaporation of steam. So first of all, we will study about what is the change of state. What is the definition of change of state of substance? When a substance changes from one state to another, the process is called as change of substance. For example, when the substance changes from one state to other, for example, when ice cube is taken out of the refrigerator, what happens? It immediately starts melting. So the solid form of ice is now converted into the other form, that is liquid. So there is change in the state. So this change of state is the change of state of the substance. Okay, understood? Other example, I'm giving you example of camphor, Kapoor. Okay, now the camphor is the solid substance. Okay, it is a solid substance. It is in solid state. So what happens when you keep the camphor open? What will happen? It will start evaporating. Okay, so how it will evaporate? It evaporates in the form of gaseous. So again here, solid to gaseous. So if the substance changes from one state to another state, this process is called as change of substance, change of state of substance. Even wax also, when you melt the wax, it becomes liquid. And after cooling the wax, again it returns it to its original position. So this is the change of substance. Okay, the next, I have given three states, that is solid, liquid, and gaseous. Okay, in solid, we are going to study about iron. Okay, is air. Okay. So, in solid form, the water is iron is having some shape. Okay. So, iron is a solid form. So, solid form has a shape. Even it has a definite volume. For example, if sugar is a solid form, if it falls on the ground, what will happen? You can immediately pick it and keep it in the container. Okay. But if the water falls down, what will happen? Does the water have the shape? No, water does not have shape. If you pour the water in the glass, it will take the shape of the glass. If you pour the water in the container, it will take the shape of the container. Okay, means that water is taking the shape of the container. Okay, so does it have the volume? Yes, it has a specific volume. Why it is having a specific volume? Because it is taking the shape of the glass container. Okay, and other point is that when the water is fallen on the ground, if the water is fallen on the ground, what happens? It flows, it moves from one place to other, and everywhere you can see the water. It does not stand at one place. Okay, then the third example is of air. So air is a gaseous example. Then again, it does not have any shape and a volume. It does not have definite volume as the pressure of the gases changes. So here what we have studied, that solid, shape, well, it has definite volume, where liquid is having definite shape, but it is having a specific volume, whereas gaseous does not have definite shape as well as it does have definite volume. Okay, the next thing, heat and changes of the physical state. Now what happens, whatever, some things melt when we are heating, or they change the state from solid to liquid or liquid to gaseous. Or changes the substances or loses the heat. Now the example of wax. Now wax is a solid. Okay. When I heat the wax, what will happen? It will convert into liquid. Okay. Then again, I will take the example of ice. I'm giving you example of ice is a solid state example. When you keep out of the refrigerator, what will happen? It will melt. Okay. Then other example is ghee. So when ghee is a somewhat solid substance, when you heat it, what will happen? Immediately it melts in the after heating. Okay. So some substances changes their state from solid to liquid, or liquid to gaseous, or gaseous to liquid, or liquid to solid on heating or on cooling. This is called physical state. Means if we are applying heating or cooling to some substances, what happens? There is change in the state of the substance. Okay. Now here, temperature and thermometer. As you know, temperature is related to what? The temperature is related to warm or hot substances. Okay. Means what? When in a container, if you keep a water to boil, what will happen? The water starts boiling. So you can see the water is having some certain temperature. Some temperature has been attended by the water. Can you get off in that water? Because you're seeing that the water is boiling, and if you put, you understand by this that the temperature has been given by heating the water. Okay, if the substance is very hot, we get scalds, means burns. Okay. We get burns. Now, how can we measure the temperature? Using thermometer for measuring the temperature. Okay, the measuring temperature is done in which degree unit? That is degree Celsius. Okay, degree Celsius is the unit of measuring the temperature. Now, in the market, there are different types of thermometer. Even you have done the projects of thermometer. In that thermometer, you have drawn different types of thermometers, such as digital thermometer. Okay. So, what does the thermometer means? That the thermometer uses that it measures the temperature of the hot or cold body. Okay. Now, what is the means how the thermometer works? Now in thermometer, the liquid called mercury is present. Okay, here you can see in the picture, the red color thing is there. Okay, so how much they think, okay, even when at home also you are having some fever, so what your mother does immediately, she takes a thermometer, she puts in your, keep it near your body, and she may sees the temperature, and if the temperature is more than 90 or 100, she immediately goes to the doctor. Yes, And if the temperature is not too high, she tries the home remedies. Okay, in the last chapter, we have studied about home remedies. So some home remedies also can be done if you are having normal fever. But if the fever is very high, that time you have to go to the doctor. Okay. So here what is important that we are using thermometers for measuring the temperature, the fever which we are having in our body. Okay, to know for our knowing, we are using the thermometer. Okay. The next, boiling. Now, what is boiling? Now, see, one example I will give you that in a vessel, I have taken some water and I have kept on a gas and I have started heating that water. What will happen? After, immediately, you will not see the water bubbles in it. It will take some time to heat. After heating, the water has taken a temperature. After that, you can see continuous bubbles rising from that water as faster as the red surface. And even you can see the steam mixing in the air. Most of the time, mummy khana bana rahi hai, toh you can see curry or what she has kept on the gas. You can see it is boiling and you can see the steam that is mixing with the air. So this is called as boiling of water. When you see bubbles in the liquid thing, that is called boiling of the water or of that substance. Okay, the pure boiling is at 1000 degrees Celsius. Okay, so this is the boiling point. Now there is one more new word, that is condensation. So what is condensation? Now I have kept the water for boiling and even I can see the bubbles in it. So I know that this water is boiled completely. Now what I will do? I will off the gas. I will stop the heating. So what will happen? The water vapor will start cooling slowly. And what will happen? And the water will come to its original position. So this process is called as condensation. So condensation, boiling. In this, taken into liquid point and the condensation point is one and the same. Means there is no difference in boiling and cooling. So to clear your doubt, one more example I will give, that nowadays rainy season is there. Okay. So doctor advise you to the boil. What is freezing? The conversion of the liquid state into solid state is called as freezing. Means, when we are making the ice cream, it is in the liquid form. But when we are keeping in the fridge, what happens? The liquid state changes into the solid state. Same in case of ice also. When we are keeping the water, which is in the liquid state in the freezer, what happens? It becomes in the solid state. So what is the definition of freezing? Conversion of the liquid state into solid state is called as freezing. The temperature at which the freezing occurs is called as freezing. Means the temperature at which the water changes into the ice or ice cream converts into the solid state, that process is called as freezing. point. That process is called as freezing point. Generally, water freezes into ice at 0 degree Celsius. At 0 degree Celsius, and the temperature inside the fridge is minus degrees. So whatever things we are keeping in the refrigerator, it cools immediately as the temperature is in minus degree Celsius. Okay, the water kept in the fridge, or it becomes cooler and cooler, that is the temperature is falling. Means when the water is kept in the normal water which is outside the refrigerator is at normal temperature. Okay, but when you keep in the refrigerator, it becomes cooler. At the certain temperature, water does not get cooler. Now, in the refrigerator, it has a certain limit of cooling the water. Beyond that cooling water, the temperature cannot fall. So, the last stage of the cooling water is the water is freezing. That is the last stage of the of freezing. So, this freezing, this point is called as freezing point of water. Okay, so this point is called as freezing point of water. Again, I will tell you what is freezing. Conversion of liquid state into solid state is called as freezing. And the temperature at which the freezing occurs, means when the freezing occurs actually, that time it is called as freezing point of the water. When you see the water has completely converted into the water, ice, that time that is the freezing point of the water. Here you can see even wax and glass also there. Now there are various uses of change in the physical state. Now you can see that paraffin wax is melted and candles are made out of it. Okay, paraffin wax is a wax which is melted and you can get different types of candles in the market available. Okay, then dry ice. What is dry ice? It is a solid carbon dioxide which is used for preparation of ice creams. But why it is used in solid carbon dioxide is a dry ice. Why it is used for making ice cream? Because it keeps the ice cream in the frozen condition. Okay, then liquid nitrogen is used for animal husbandry, means it keep practice to keep the sperms alive. Okay, means whatever sperms are there, it keeps the sperms alive. That is done by the liquid nitrogen which is used in animal husbandry. Then the next point is glass. Now glass is again made up of molten silica. Now what is molten silica? It means that the sand or silica that is melted to make a glass. The glass is formed with the help of melting sand. Okay, when sand is melted, we get the formation of glass. Then the next is ornaments are made up of gold and silver. You can see that many girls are wearing ornaments which are made up of gold and silver. So that can be also melted and give different shapes, looks to that ornament, so that it look attractive. To make attractive, gold and silver ornaments are melted for giving different attractive shapes. Okay, then the next point is tools are made from molten iron. So different tools are made from iron. So iron is also melted to make different tools, to make tools. Okay, so these are all examples of melting. Now the sublimation. Now what does the sublimation means? In the first, what we have studied, that the liquid changes into the solid changes into liquid and liquid changes into gaseous on heating. Okay, but in this sublimation state, the solid substance directly changes into gaseous, that is, changes into the vapor form. This process is called as sublimation. This process is called as sublimation. Now, here you can see that iodine particles, here salt is taken in the funnel, and you can see the iodine particles has been stuck to the funnel, and the cotton is put on the funnel so that it does not evaporate, Actually, that means that the iodine is seen during this experiment. As you all know, in salt, iodine is present. Okay, when we take the salt and heat it and keep the funnel covered on it, you see the iodine particles on the funnel. Okay, these iodine particles are seen during experiment in laboratories. You can see these iodine particles only in the laboratories. Lab mein hum log jab experiment karte hai, tab we can, that time we can see the iodine particles. Now, just you have to remember what is sublimation. Sublimation is the change of solid substance directly into the gaseous or vapor without first changing into liquid. What? That the solid substance changes to liquid and then it changes to gaseous. But in this process, the solid substances changes directly to the liquid substances. So this process is called as sublimation. So there is difference in, there is little bit difference in the sublimation method. Now, the next point is, here in the picture you can see glass. Okay, now glass. How is the glass? You can see that the glass is transparent. You can see whatever is poured in the glass. For example, water or sherbet. You can see in the glass what is there in the glass. Which type of sherbet or liquid is there in the glass. That you can see. Why you can see? Because glass is transparent. Then second picture is the chalk powder. Okay, now in our school, we have seen lot of chalk powder fall on the floor. So that chalk powder is dissolving in water. Yes, does it dissolve in water? No, it does not dissolve in water. Okay, it is a just a powder material. Then the next picture you can see, that is rod. Now rod are made up of iron. And these ions, how they are? They are opaque and dark, and even they are hard. Opaque means what? We are not able to see inside it, and they are dark. Okay, they are hard also. Then the fourth picture is of door. Now door is a wooden. Can you see from your house who is next out of your house? No, we cannot see. Yes, we can see only when we have the door eye hole. From the eye hole, we can see who is outside the door. But if the whole door is made up of wood, we cannot see from one side to another side. So door is an opaque thing. Okay, the substances can be identified by studying their properties. Now here we have studied their properties, that glass is transparent, then chalk powder is fine and it may dissolve, it will not dissolve in water, then rod is hard, it is opaque and dark, while door is opaque, we cannot see. So these are the properties of the substances. Now we are going to study in detail what are the properties of substances. Now what are the properties of substances? First thing is brittleness. I have given you the example of brittleness. Now see, in our school we are taking a chalk, and if the chalk by mistakenly falls down from our hand, what will happen? It will break immediately. Means what happens? That the chalk breaks immediately. So it is very brittle. It is weak. Okay. The substance break into small pieces or particles. Such substances are called as brittle. Brittle means they are weak and easily break. So this property is called as brittleness. And example is chalk. The second property is elasticity. So what is elasticity? When the substances changes their shape with the, now here is the, I'm giving the example of rubber. When you stretch the rubber with force, what happens? It changes its original position. Okay. But when you, when the force is removed from that rubber, what will happen? It will again come back to its original shape and size. So this property is called as elasticity. So rubber is the example of elasticity. The third property is fluidity. What is the third property? Fluidity. the liquid flows downward on the sloping surface. Means what? The liquid flows from one direction to the another direction. This property is called as fluidity. For example, water fallen on the ground or oil fall on the floor. So it immediately moves from one place to other and it flows in flow in downward or sloping surface. Okay, so we cannot collect immediately the liquid things. Density. Now density means what? Now suppose iron and wood, both are having mass. Mass means weight. Both are having weight. And the mass of the different substances have same volume can be different. Means iron and wood, both are having same weight. But their volume can be different. Uska jo volume hai, that can be different. The difference in the their density may matter the greater density and the lesser density. Okay. According to the density, the this is one of the property that can identify the difference of the two substances. Means what? Iron and wood are having same weight. So how will you identify which one is having higher density and lower density? So you can do this thing with the help of the substance volume. So one will be the greater density and heavier than the other. Okay. Then solubility. What is solubility? In water is an example. In water, salt also dissolves and sugar also dissolves. So that means that it is having the property of solubility. So water is a good example in which salt and water, sugar both dissolve. So this property of dissolving is called as solubility. So water is a soluble. Water is soluble solvent. Okay, so solubility means what? It has the property of getting dissolved all the things. So in water, salt and sugar dissolve. So it is having the property of solubility. Then next is transparency. What is the meaning of transparency? Means from one substance you can see the things of the other side. This property is called as transparent. For example, glass. From glass you can see, fish tank is one of the good example. You can see from one side of the glass to the other end of the glass. So that is transparent. So this property of the substance is called as transparency. Even in the water also you can see. Why I have given you the example of fish tank? Because in fish tank glass as well as water is also present. So you can have both the examples in one example only. So here, what are the properties we have studied? That first three properties were brittleness, elasticity, fluidity, and density, solubility, and transparency. These are the six properties of the substances. So what are the six properties of the substances? Brittleness, elasticity, fluidity, density, solubility, and transparency. Now we are going to study what are metals. Now metals are found in the form of minerals deep in the inside the crust of the earth. Means in the inside of the earth's crust we find most of the metals in the form of minerals. Okay, which substances we found in the earth's crust? That is copper, gold, iron, aluminium. These are all the examples of metals. So minerals from the earth crust are processed to obtain metals. So whatever minerals are obtained from the earth crust, we cannot use in them in the same form. So they have to be processed and they have to be undergoing under the processing. After that, they obtain the metal. So in daily life, we are using different types of metals. Here you can see uses of metals in the daily life. Now metals produce a ringing sound. This is also called as property of sonority of metals. Means what happens when the metals falls down from your hand? It is having a ringing sound. For example, in our home, any vessel falls down. So what happens? A continuous ringing sound comes. So this ringing sound is called as a property. This property is called as sonority of the metals. What it is called? The ringing sound of the metals is called as sonority of the metals. Now the properties of the substances and properties of the metals both are different. Okay? Both are different. So let's learn what are the properties of metals. Metals can be converted into sheets. Now metals can be converted into sheets by hammering. Sheets means they can be made straight into the form of sheet by hammering. So this property is called as malleability. Okay, I will show you the picture after explanation. The process, the metal can be converted into sheets by hammering. This property is called as malleability. In malleability, what happens? The metal is converted into sheet by hammering. This process is called, this property is called as malleability. Then what is ductility? The metals which are there, they are stretched and drawn into the wire forms. Means you can see different wire, group of wires. So this property is called as ductility. Ductility means the metal is stretched and drawn into wires. Means they are given the structure of wires. So this property is called as ductility. Metals like silver, gold, copper, platinum can be drawn into the fine wires. You can see gold wire, silver wire, copper wire, platinum wire. This can be drawn into the fine wires. Then thermal conductivity. Now what is thermal conductivity? Thermal conductivity, I would like to give you the example of pressure cooker. Now what happens? We cook the rice in the pressure cooker. Now if the metal allows the heat to flow through it, that time only the rice will cook. If the metal does not allow the heat to flow through it, will the rice cook? No. So this property, that metal allows the heat to flow through them, is called as thermal conductivity. Thermal conductivity example is pressure cooker. That means the pressure cooker is allowing the heat to flow inside it. The metal is allowing to heat to flow inside it, and afterwards we get a cook rice or a dal. Okay, if it does not allow, the rice or dal would not have been cooked. So this is one of the property, that is thermal conductivity. Now electricity flows through the metal. Okay, now this is property is called as electrical conductivity. Means in all metals the electricity generated may be more or less. So this property is called as electrical conductivity property. Okay, now here malleability picture, you can see the person is hammering and making it straight. For example, the nail which has been crooked, you can hammer it continuously to make it straight. Here you can see the group of wires present which can be stretched, and a group of wire, that is the property of ductility. Now pressure cooker is the property of thermal conductivity. Okay, now in this chapter what we have learned, that the substances are having three different types of states. What are the three different states? Solid, liquid and gaseous state. Then the temperature is measured through the with the help of thermometer. Okay, then the heat causes change in the state. That means heat is one of the factor which changes the state of the substances. Then what are the properties of the substances? Hardness, elasticity, brittleness, fluidity, density, solubility and transparency. We have studied this in detail. Then metal forms a separate group from the substance. Now I told you that substances and metals differ from each other. While substances have different properties and metals are having different properties. So what the properties metal is having? Metals are malleability, ductility, thermal conductivity, electrical conductivity, sonority, luster and characteristic color. What is the meaning of luster? Means the metals are given shining. So this process is called as luster. Okay, so question answer part we will do